Hi, I'm Sally Ride. I was the first American woman astronaut. I got to go into space twice in the space shuttle. My mission today is getting kids excited about science, math, and technology through my company, Sally Ride Science. A lot's changed since I went into space. Today, kids can learn about science and explore space too, through their computers. I've asked a friend from Google to come in and show us how. Come on in, Greg.
Hi, Sally.
Hi.
Ready to blast off?
Absolutely.
Like all space missions, we begin on Earth, Google Earth. So let's view the new sky feature. So here we are in San Diego. To view the sky, we click on the sky button. And this is how the sky looks above us right now.
Oh, that's cool. Looks like we're flying.
Yeah, where to first?
Let's start in our solar system.
Okay, let's check out Saturn.
So you can actually see it moving. Did you know it takes Saturn 12 years to go around the sun? Let's move out of our solar system. Can you see constellations? Sometimes they're hard to picture from Earth.
Yeah, they can be, but not in Google Earth.
Ah, that's much better.
Do you have a favorite?
Oh, they're all good. Why don't we start with Taurus?
No problem.
While we're here, let's check out the Crab Nebula. It's in Taurus.
Okay. Is that a star?
Not anymore. The star exploded as a supernova back in 1054, and it was so bright that Chinese astronomers said they could see it during the day. So no trip to space would be complete without looking at the Orion Nebula. Can we see that? It's right nearby.
Yeah, that sounds great.
This is a stellar nursery. You're seeing hundreds of stars being born. So we just saw the Crab Nebula, a star that had died, and now we're seeing hundreds of stars in their birth stages.
We've also included a lot of this information. Here it says the image was taken by the Hubble Space Telescope.
What a great way to explore the universe.
If you'd like to try the new sky feature, download the latest version of Google Earth and click on the sky button.